I think the most painful was my term in prison. I just felt something was wrong, that at my age, I should spend over 10 months being in prison. And I felt something was unfair, as though now at this part of my life, I should sit in prison. And that to me was supposed to be the prize that I got in this country.
Since 1966, Abie Nathan has been infuriating the Israeli politicians with his private peace initiatives. In 1988, he was put in prison for meeting with Arafat.
Talking to Arafat, and I had to pay for it in prison. Living among murderers and drug dealers, small rooms. It was a horrible memory I have till today. Very cruel. Difficult even for me to forgive the people that sent me there. Very difficult.
A few months before the Six-Day War, he secretly flew a single-engine plane to Cairo in a futile attempt to meet with the Egyptian president, Abdel Nasser. Since 1972, his pirate peace ship has broadcast reason and peace to millions of listeners. A few days after this interview, he sank the ship.
Just take it out to sea, make sure you don't pollute the sea. I don't talk about sinking it. I want her to rest, so lay her to rest. Well, she did its thing. It's like all of us. We do our things and we pass on.
The חבר שלי, אבי נתן, ישב שנתיים בצוהר על מה שרבין יקבל פרס נובל לשלשער.
Usually politicians feel that the making of peace is strictly the monopoly of politicians and that there is no role for the individual. And throughout history, it is the individual that spoke out, created a climate that enabled politicians to change their minds or to change their policies.